Hi everyone, welcome back to this month's episode of Book Banter, presented by the Public Library of Youngstown and Mahoning County. My name is Alex, and joining me today is my friend and fellow librarian, Sarah.
Hi.
And we are going to be discussing Escaping Mr. Rochester by L.L. McKinney.
And in Escaping Mr. Rochester, we have a retelling of Jane Eyre, the classic novel. And in this one, though, we start out with Jane waiting for a carriage to take her to Thornfield Hall to be the governess for Adele. And when she gets there, she feels like things aren't quite what they seem. She's used to kind of being treated a little bit differently, as she is a Black woman. And so she's trying to navigate, you know, her expectations of everything and how Adele is behaving. And then she meets Edward Rochester and starts to kind of get some strange vibes from him. Come to find out that he actually has his wife Bertha locked up in the attic for nefarious reasons. And now Jane and Bertha go about together trying to escape Rochester's clutches and to get Adele out of there as well. And in the process, we get some feelings between Jane and Bertha. So yeah, that's, you know, a quick summary of Escaping Mr. Rochester. So Alex and I will give our thumbs up or thumbs down or thumbs meh on the book. Are you ready?
Yeah.
All right. 3, 2, 1.
Yes.
Yeah. I it really was. I loved the classic. It's one that I have actually reread like many times. And I loved all the little nods to it.
Yeah.
But yeah, this was fantastic.
I'm embarrassed to admit that I've never actually read the original. So I didn't have a lot to compare to, but I still really loved it. I think that it's probably safe to say that L.L. McKinney is the queen of sapphic retellings.
Yes.
In my opinion, or at least what her books that I've read. But yeah, this one like really takes you on a ride and doesn't let go from like almost the very beginning.
Yeah, because one of the things we get is both girls' points of view.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, we start with Jane, but it almost goes back and forth every time. So we get Jane, we get Bertha. So you know right away that Rochester is not a good guy.
Yeah.
And, like, I feel like in the original, he wasn't necessarily likable.
Yeah.
But, like, he's just pure evil in this.
Yeah.
Like, he was just, and you know that right away.
Mm-hmm. But he has, like, everyone else fooled except for, like, the people who are, like, in his little,
circle.
Yeah.
Yeah, I do wish we'd had a little bit more about how he was able to convince them to, like, stay on and how he was paying them with everything. But, I mean, I didn't even think about it until the very, very end. And I was like, oh, how was he keeping like Grace and Marsters and the other guy whose name I just blanked on?
I was just like,
yeah. Yeah. Something like that. Yeah.
It's a D.
It starts with a D. I know that.
We're terrible. Sorry.
Sorry, everyone. but he's, I mean, even Bertha says he's very charming and that's how he gets everyone.
Yeah. He's a sly guy.
Yeah. I know you said you didn't read the original.
Mm-hmm.
I had to read it in high school and like I loved it. Every few years I do end up rereading it. There were a lot of references to the original.
I like know enough about it to like was able to pick out some of them, but like not enough.
Yeah. To, like... So in the original, Bertha starts a fire.
Okay.
Shortly after Jane arrives, just like in this one, there is a fire at the end that destroys Thornfield.
Mm-hmm.
Blanche is kind of the worst.
Yeah.
And Grace is always like real shady throughout the original as well. Rochester does like kind of start courting Jane and buying her gifts and things like that. So it hit like all the like major plot points.
Mm-hmm.
It just twisted them into Rochester being the bad guy, which I was fine with.
Who else? Who were like some of your favorites? Any character? Who was your favorite villain of the Barbarian Fallberry? Without giving anything away.
I can't say who it is because that would give it away.
Yeah.
Is that who you were gonna say too?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah. Yeah, I mean, you really don't find out until the last like 50 pages.
Yeah, what about that plot twist?
And it's funny because I had been wondering, I was like, I wonder where this character is. I wonder where she is. And I was expecting her to show up like at the wedding.
Yeah.
And then I was like, oh my gosh, yeah. I can't believe I didn't see that one coming.
It's like a one that you think is coming and then it doesn't come and then comes again.
Yeah. And there it was.
Yeah. So good though.
I thought Bertha was like, I think between Jane and Bertha, Bertha was probably my favorite. Mm-hmm.
Yeah, I really liked her. I adored Adele. I would honestly love to have like a story of Adele in her teen years. Like, in the, you know, if there was like a sequel or like a companion novel or something.
Yeah, that would be good. Mm-hmm. As she kind of comes into her own after being raised by Jane and Bertha.
Yeah, Adele is the ward of Rochester, and who Jane is the
governess,
gosh, thank you, throughout the book, and she's just like whip smart and has like this fire about her that I really loved. And I think, like, I don't know, I feel like the little girls these days, like my daughter and all the little ones coming up, are kind of like all have that same energy. So I thought that was kind of
And I did feel like the characters are all kind of like ramped up from the original, like they're really exaggerated in a good way, but that they're also modern but still historically accurate. Like one of my favorite things about the original Jane Eyre was that Jane always, like, she stood her ground and kind of stuck to her morals. Once she realized that Rochester was married, she was like, nope, not doing this. And Jane in Escaping Mr. Rochester is still very much like that. She has that very strong line of right, this is wrong, and she doesn't cross it. She does the right thing, even when it's not the easiest thing.
Right.
I don't know. I just loved Bertha, though. Like, she was just, I always felt she was supposed to be a little bit sympathetic in the original.
Yeah.
And this one, it's like, you could just tell she was angry.
Yeah.
And I loved it. I know. She has that one line when she's pretending to pray to hide the fact that Jane had snuck in, and and Grace hears her, and Grace says something about like such hateful prayers. Bertha just stares her down and was like, hateful prayers for hateful people. And I was like, oh yes.
They were, lots of strong female characters. What about the little romance between Bertie and Jane?
I loved it, and it was just so sweet to kind of like watch it grow. And you know, I remember reading it and I was just like, oh, there it is. Like the first time Bertie sees Jane, and it's like, you know, the sun streaming in. I was like, oh, it's so like cliche, but so cute and sweet. And then, and the letters they start writing each other, it's
so sweet. That was probably actually one of my favorite parts, but like that wasn't like super like intense, you know, or like whatever, but like, just like a different aspect of the book, I guess, like the romance within the mystery and the suspense, I guess.
And that was really one other thing too about like the necklace from Bertie's grandmother. Jane starts calling her Bertie, which is why we just automatically switched calling Bertha Bertie. But I love that the necklace that she got from her grandmother still had the meaning that her grandmother intended. I was like, oh, that was that was really sweet. I had to go back and look because I remember on the first part, because you get parts within the chapters, but there's a quote, and I was like, I think this is, I know this one for part one was from the book, but I went and double checked for each of the parts. The beginning quote is from the original. And I was like, I'm pretty sure that all of these were, that's how many times I've read the original. I really had fun with this.
It was a good one.
I wouldn't be mad again if there was a sequel, if we got like Adele as a teenager, kind of the glimpses of you know, how things turned out for Jane and Bertie
and like where they end up, I guess.
All right. So once again, Alex and I read Escaping Mr. Rochester by L.L. McKinney. We do have copies available at our branches that you can check out. We also have the ebook and e-audiobook on Libby. So thanks for joining us, and we will see y'all next month.
Bye. Bye, everyone.